Hi, I'm Chad, and I'm here with my shop assistant, Linus. And today, I'm going to be turning some U. U is something I've never turned before, so I'm kind of curious to see how it goes. I'm going to try to make a multi-lobe bowl out of this section right here. So let's go to the bandsaw, get this cut down to size, and get started. So I've taken the blank off the lathe because as I was making a couple of those last cuts, I could tell that it had shifted a little bit and wasn't where I'd originally positioned it. So to make sure it doesn't continue and come loose or anything, just to be safe, went ahead and took it off, and I'm going to remount it with the spur drive, get it in there nice and secure, and then continue turning. And with something irregular like this, that can happen, and you know, just gotta roll with it. So this is close to our finished bowl, but I've still got a fair amount of work to do. Obviously, I need to sand away the tool marks, and I'm also going to give a little better profile to this flat spot right here. Because of the vibration, the piece was significantly off balance. There's a lot more mass down here that I had to remove. And because of that vibration, there's more tool marks than I would like. But overall, the wood turns nicely. The challenging thing about this is you have grain going in every direction, so it was kind of tough at times to get a nice clean cut. So there's going to be a little bit of sanding because of that, some grain tear out. Overall, it's cool. It looks nice. So having never turned this before, I probably shouldn't have started with something quite so big. It seems like it'd be better suited for smaller pieces. You know, a lot of people make some really cool vessels out of it, and I'm sure that's what I'll do with some of the other pieces from that big chunk I've got. Overall, I guess I would say I recommend trying you if you have a chance. You know, start with something a little smaller than what I started with. It's pretty flexible, pretty forgiving, it cuts easily. Just be sure that your tools are nice and sharp. Since the grain is going to kind of go every direction, sharp tools are going to help you reduce your grain tear out and get some smoother cuts. As far as sanding, I'm not quite sure how easy it is. I guess I'm going to find out in the next couple days. I'm probably going to let it dry a little before I try to sand out those tool marks. But let me spray it down real quick so you can get a better look at the grain. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, hit the like button, and I hope you'll subscribe to my channel and check out my future videos. You can find some of the pieces from my videos in my Etsy shop. That's chadeameswoodworks.etsy.com, or find me on social media, Instagram and Facebook at chadeameswoodworks, and there's links to all that in the description below. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the project, and I hope you'll come back for the next one. Thanks for watching.